video's tape.
Last race of the night for the Classics.
Meeting final,
decider of the National Series for 2013.
9th and 10th place in each race. Haven't scored any points yet tonight. So the points championship is still very much open.
So as Mr. Goddard said, championship still in the offing, as neither of the protagonists for the championship this season has so far scored any points so far this evening. Points in order coming the way of Andy Steward and Charlie Chambry. And that man there, Roger Wright, doing well in his Mark 1 Escort tonight, having done the engine, rebuilt it again ready for Hemsford a couple of weeks ago, and wasn't on the pace then, but on the slightly smaller tracks such as Birmingham and Northampton, Roger tends to find the drive just that little bit better suited for his 2-litre Pinto engine. Charlie Chambry having taken a brace of 2 second places tonight. Rob Mantanga, well, he got a fourth or a fifth in the last one. Good to see Robert out again after having a few months off after Ipswich this year. 924, one of the all-time best-looking classic hot rods at the wheel of Stuart Wright, and alongside him the Austin A40 car of Graham Boyd. Both not really featured in the results so far tonight, but hopefully that might change in the final. So, Andy Stuart. See where Andy is. Is he out there? Well, we can see Mr. Foxlow. And Andy's been brought back amongst the stars, having won the two heats. So an automatic upgrade from blue grey to star in this meeting final. Starting alongside Tim Foxlow. Number 8, Daz Owen. And then we have 30, Jamie Bowring, and 333, Lee Wood. That's at the very back, 657 Neil Smith. So just waiting for the clearance of the debris that the bang has brought to bear in their last race. Putting the obligatory cement down. Over on the far side, well, some contrasting fortunes amongst the stars tonight. Foxlow driving car 144, really hooked on the pace in heat one, got an excellent fourth place in the final. Well, the second race, I should say, got tangled up with J.U. Bowring. Bowring was awarded fourth in that heat. A little surprised that, because I thought that he'd spun in the final, but obviously he must have come back into the results. Foxlow didn't feature in the 10. Stuart, though, in contrast, having won two hits. And Daz Owen, the man who's made Hemsford his own this season, having won the veterans final in the height of the summer. And on bonfire night, he was in a class of his own, winning the final there as well.
Get the lost time in the last race.
In front of a big crowd. Very popular meeting, Hemsford. Big one following for the National Hot Rods. Lee Wood, he was on flyer, really, at Hemsford a few weeks ago. And tonight he said the car wasn't quite as well fettled. Every car, every track, having that little bit of a difference, surface, size, conditions, how much debris the bangers are put down, for example, but Lee not quite on the pace as much. Now, will 161 Dan Holden or 20 Day Fry get into the points? Well, at Hemsford, they could certainly do so. It's certainly harder work in a smaller track like Birmingham. Neil Smith at the back.
as a red top almost. So it's likely going to go for a clutch start very shortly then. No use the pace car this time. Good evening, Sonny Howard up here in race control. Involved in all sorts of facets of oval racing over the years. And Sonny, of course, runs the pickup truck series on the 1.5 mile oval at Rockingham, as well as the circuit. So good to have Sonny Howard here with us. Help prepare Andy Stewart's escort. And would dearly love, I'm sure, to see it take a hat-trick. Next classic hot rod racer, Carl Checkley, also with us.
Getting ready for the drop of a hammer in the final.
So we are in the starter's orders. The last classic hot rod event of the season. Race championship of the evening. Let's get
ready. Here we go.
Here we go.
Oh, barreling all over the place again.
Watch for that one, Andy Stewart, 198
Stewart looking to chase down those ahead of him. Take the hat-trick. Foxlow trying to get it clear of barreling in this final. Slams the lights on as he moves into turn one. There's Lee Wood. 161. Dan Holden, heir apparent to the points title. And he's ahead of Dave Fry in car 20.
Daniel Holden is 11.
Steve Wright not quite on the pace tonight as Foxler looks for his inside. Roger Wright then on a flyer as Dave Goddard had said a moment ago. He's got clear to Shembri. Although I would differ with his analysis of Roger's performance this year, having won two finals at Northampton. Looking at Stewart now on the inside of Boyd. Well, he's trying to get there. The A40 pilot trying to hold him out as he's moving to turn three. There's a dive on the inside from Stewart. Meanwhile, Darren Owen and Tim Foxlow playing games as they move through turns one and two. 2 litre power versus Foxlow. Second place, and the man in the lead, 24, Roger Wright. There's a handsome lead now ahead of Shembri, then goes Stewart. 22, Rob Bantanga, 445, Graham Boyd. Number 8, Daz Owen, and 144, Tim Foxlow. Through these laps in this last event of the night and the last race of the season for the CHRs. Stewart there having passed Shembri. Now, can the man driving car 198 reel in the pace of 24 Roger Wright in tonight's grand final? That is a big one. There is Roger flying through. All credit to the man with the long hair, veteran of the raceways. And Roger looking for his third final win of season 2013. Great battle between Daz Owen and Tim Foxlow as they look to try and get the better of Graham Boyd in 445. 22 Rob Montanga ahead of them, then 121 Charlie Shembri. There goes Shembri. Owen and Foxlow, and then we have 657 Neil Smith. Meanwhile, at the back, those who were in the hunt for this season's overall points title, and it's again 20 Day Fry having just got the better of 161 Dan Holden, but not in the hunt for the big points, so therefore Dave Fry will not reel in sufficient points to snatch the title from Holden for this season. Great battle though amongst the lower order. Foxlow there right now with Montanga and Neil Smith. Held out Owen. Neil Smith trying to force his way past Tim Foxlow. There's Lee Wood. And there's Roger Wright, your race leader, having made a real exhibition of this race tonight. Having lap Bowering. There is 198 Andy Stewart in second place. Having lap 924 Stewart Wright. There goes Chambry. And then the big race for the lower order. And there's Dave Fry on the inside of Neil Smith. We have three laps left. Two laps left for Roger Wright. Absolutely flying tonight is Roger. To lap Lee Wood, second place, 198 Andy Stewart. Chambry. There we are, checker flag, and Roger Wright, the winner of his third final 2013. A superb back-to-flag victory, started from the clutch start, and the old boy, the genial chatterbox that he is, 24 Roger Wright, wins the third final, a long way clear of the rest of the field.
Stay fly across the line 7, Daniel Holland across the line 9.
Pretty clean race. Well, that therefore confirms it.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you, although he finished outside the points, the 2013 Classic Hot Rod points champion is 161 Daniel Holden. The drivers cut loose to end their season with a flurry of donuts. One more exuberance, the Golden Holden. They have finished outside the points tonight, but 7th place, 1 minute up today, in Fly to overhaul him, and Dan has done it, national champion and now points champion.
Dan Holden City tonight for all the classics in celebration of a great year's racing.
Season.
Good bit of showboating by all drivers there, well done.
See you on track in a moment.
Excellent, great weekend.